On the brink, 12 days, 12 hours, and 60 minutes after the blackout.
I've tried everything I know.
It's about to overload.
Wait, didn't you say MacArthur overloaded safety limiters?
Why are you talking about MacArthur?
Alex, isolate encryption sequence 17B on the grid.
Reactor capacity and zero.
Got it. We're in. Now what?
There's an emergency shutdown.
It worked! The reactor's stabilizing!
We're not done yet. The reactor hasn't been able to send the energy anywhere, so...
FPT overloaded. Relief pressure immediately.
The reserves are about to burst. We have to release the energy.
How?
Temporary transmission should send the...
It's quiet. Finally. The reactor. Is it safe?
It is. But the force has moved the MPT dish off its alignment.
How bad is it? Can we realign it?
The controls are up in the tower. But let's see if there's any helium left first.
On the brink. Desperate, Sarah uses an unconventional method to access the reactor controls. Isaac reacts swiftly and shuts down the reactor before it can destroy Tombaugh. Still, danger persists as the reactor's power has filled the MPT battery beyond its limits. Isaac activates a brief MPT transmission, but the built-up energy is released with such force that the MPT dish is knocked off its alignment. Recorded 5th of October 2054, 12 days, 12 hours, and 16 minutes after the blackout. So we got the reactor all. Well, we got all the reactor information. Okay. So in brackets at the top it says the warm paper shows sketches and detailed information about the MPT dish, the MPT battery, and the fusion reactor. On the back it says, smile like this is a joke, they're monitoring us through ASEs somehow. You see the numbers. McKay said reactor's falling but all data looks fine. Mistake or did he lie? He lied, people need to know, use the intercom, smile again. McKay will kill us. He won't go that far and we have no choice, you heard them. We can't abandon the MPT, can't abandon Earth. We have to do something, grab that mic. MPT reserves close to overload. MPT target not found. Adjust alignment. Reactor dormant. Helium free. It's going too fast. Insert helium free into the reactor. Phase 1 evacuation. East and West units cover the East and West sides of the Tombaugh facility, respectively. Phase 1 is split up into 6 steps. 1. A malfunction has occurred in the reactor around Tombaugh. Employees in your area. Resistance may be met with force only if absolutely necessary. Number 2. West units assembles employees to helium-free storage to load all remaining canisters into the designated monorails or monorails. When ready, wait for East unit. Number 3. East unit leads employees to crew quarters and have them clear it out. Limit personal items to a minimum. Only essential supplies are allowed on the arcs. When ready, move to West unit. Number 4. Board the employees onto the monorail, to the monorails. East unit escorts them to Copernicus Moon Hub. Number 5. West unit splits up into evacuation crews 1 and 2. Crews 1 and 2 escort helium-free to COP, Moon Hub, and extract COP outpost and Rainhold station personnel. Number 6. Phase 2 begins approximately 3 hours after Tombaugh. Employees arrive in Copernicus Moon Hub upon MacArthur's orders. Order. West unit, East unit, backside, outward. Big Brother. With humanity's survival at stake, MacArthur left nothing to chance. Having secured a backdoor in ASE units, he kept a watchful eye on WSA colonists from his observation center. When riots broke out in Tombaugh, MacArthur used the same backdoor to overload safety limiters and turn ASE units on their unsuspecting owners. Lunar Colonist Dossier. Sarah Baker. So, professional background, software engineer, function lead engineer, stationed at Pearson Space Station. Colonist since 2048. Psychological profile, strong sense of duty, intelligent, inventive, determined. Altruistic disposition. Backside. Its subordinate performs reverse engineering on ASEs, can potentially compromise outward. So we got 13th of September 2054, MacArthur. MacArthur, I've been pondering the first phase of the plan. We must reconsider. The colonists have given up everything to dedicate their lives to keeping the MPT running. We should let them decide for themselves and come to of their own volition. They deserve better than to be lied to about the state of the reactor. Isaac Johansson, Lunar Council. 14th of September 2054. Isaac, this is a defining moment in history. The Exodus and humanity's second chance. The only one we're going to get, but the new colony cannot survive if we become splintered. We need strong arms, bright minds, and undivided commitment. We cannot jeopardize outward by leaving it to the whims of popular opinion. People need a reason to leave the MPT behind, and we're going to give it them. It's for the greater good. Wake Kathy up once we've begun phase one, then meet me in the monorail bay where she's ready when she's ready to travel. We have cryopods for her and everyone else in the arcs. I'll handle the rest of the evacuations. The end justifies the means, Isaac. We do what we must to keep them safe, even if they don't understand. William MacArthur, Lunar Council. Alright, so I'm assuming we're going down. Here.
What a waste of water.
Trophy earned, lent them your ears.
It's coolant. Water used for cooling the reactor. Some of the pipes must have burst.
You think MacArthur left any helium?
He wouldn't be so careless. But we should check, just to be sure. Go ahead, I'll join you in just a moment.
Wait, where are you going?
I'll assess the damage further on, see if the cooling is still operational. I'll be right back.
Okay. Having stabilized the reactor, Sarah and Isaac head deeper into the Tombay or Tombow facility. As Sarah starts looking for helium-3 to refuel the reactor, Isaac moves ahead to assess the damaged reactor cooling system. Recorded 5th of October 2054, 12 days, 12 hours, and 31 minutes after the blackout. September 16th, 2054. Nikki, something's off with the amount of moon rock we're putting in. We should be outputting a lot more helium. Don't know why. That's why it's making my controller go off. Nikki, something's off with the amount of moon rock we're putting in. We should be outputting a lot more helium-03 than what's listed on our charts. It's as if some of the helium is never registered, but that's against every protocol I can think of. Why would the Lunar Council sanction this? Julia. 17th of September 2054. Hi Julia, I'll admit the numbers are off, but let's not jump to conclusions. Dr. Johansson would never allow anything to jeopardize the MPT's energy signal. He's too committed to Earth, still has family living down there. Just like most of us, I'm sure it's some kind of mistake. Nikki. Is there any more information we can gather? Okay. Insert helium free into the reactor. Look for helium free in the monorail bay. Reactor cooling, research and development, Rosa LaVerde. So we got one for the database again. Empty helium-free canister. Over the years and off the records, small amounts of helium-free were moved away from the Tambao facility to an unknown location. I think I know why it might be doing that. No? Maybe not then. I thought my controller was shaking because it might be low battery, but it might just be the area, I don't know. Slowly but steadily, the Lunar Council amassed a sizable supply of helium-free with which to fuel the outward journey. When Tambao was evacuated and MacArthur unaligned the MPT in Copernicus Moon Hub, causing the blackout, only a small amount of helium-3 was left inside the reactor. As it ran out, the reactor would have sustained permanent irreparable damage if it hadn't been for Sarah and Isaac. Okay. Okay, that was definitely not what we were meant to have done. But at least we found that not to do that again, obviously. I think I've got an idea as well, obviously, how to go about what I'm meant to do again. I'm going to say this goes right in the middle. Insert helium 3 into the reactor. Come on. Yeah, that's clearly not what we're meant to do. this. No, don't put it back in. So, you know when I'm telling you to drop it on the ground next to you? And you completely keep ignoring what I'm asking you to do. There you go. Right. Let's move this so that, obviously, we're at an angle where... Let's try this now. See, that'd be a bit too far. Again. We're going to do it a different way. Maybe mine should do it. Awesome. Patience is a virtue. August 20th, 2054. Pearson Space Station. Hi, Juwan. Thanks for the custom paint job on my suit. I love it. In brackets, enjoy my end of the bargain. It wasn't easy to find. Sarah Barker, Pearson Station Lead Engineer.
Isaac? Hey!
Journey's End, 12 days and 13 hours after the blackout.
What's going on?
Stay there. I just need to,
Is that helium?
No, it's Sarah. It's for Kathy. Okay, she's waiting. She's on the ark. And I just need to get this to her.
Isaac, what are you talking about?
Three. We made three arcs for Outward.
Yeah, they're gone.
No. In the end, there was only enough fuel for two arcs, so MacArthur moved the sick, the cryo patients, to the last one. And Kathy's... She's still on the ark. Stuck here on the moon.
Wait.
But with this, I can...
Isaac, I'm sorry, but Earth is our first priority.
Earth's beyond saving, Sarah. With or without the MPT, our only hope, Kathy's only hope, is out.
Listen to me. We cannot give up on Earth. It's our home. Kathy's home. And think about Claire.
She's made her decision, and I can't go back to Earth. But with Kathy and Outward, there's a chance to start over, a new dawn. We do what we must to keep them safe, even if they don't understand.
But we can be wrong, Isaac. You said it yourself.
MacArthur's
not wrong.
Sarah! Outward is wrong! Sarah!
Everything about this is...
What's... You must understand. I have to go.
Alex? Access that terminal. Send it up. Isaac.
No. Sarah, don't do this.
I can't let you take it.
No. Stay with me.
I'm sorry, Isaac.
Okay.
I'm so sorry about that.
It's okay. Don't worry.
That's the only way I could help. Even if you'd hit me for it.
Shh. Okay, easy now, Sarah. Listen to my voice. Don't close your eyes.
Hey, buddy.
Sarah? Hey, Sarah, no.
Almost there.
No. Sarah? Sarah? It's okay. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Alex. No one needs to see this.
Journey's End. As Sarah rejoins Isaac, she catches him loading helium-free tanks into a monorail. Feverishly, he argues that Earth is lost and the helium-free is better used for Kathy, who's on board an ark that MacArthur left behind on the moon. When their argument reaches fever pitch, Isaac stabs Sarah. Despite her grave injury, Sarah distracts him and secures the helium-free out of his reach before she collapses. Recorded 5th of October 2054, 12 days and 13 hours after the blackout. Trophy earned, Environmental Analysis Part 3. Monorail Access Terminal. The terminal has trapped in and outgoing traffic in the monorail bay. A logged command shows that a monorail was sent out with critical velocity, devastating parts of the area. Weeks later, the terminal has registered additional and unusual activity. Excuse me. Okay, evacuation 2. Outward planning demands we leave for Copernicus Outpost 1 now. As ordered, collateral damage has been managed, but some casualties in crew quarters are unrecovered. Please handle them with dignity, they deserve better. Outward. We rendezvous at Copernicus Moon Hub. Evacuation crew number 1.
I wonder, right, if we... ...were able to go through that door. Give me a second, guys, let me have a look. Thank you. Right, what we're going to do, guys, is we are going to redo this all again. There's another one somewhere. Then go a little bit. So we're going to put this back, obviously, where we put it, or where it was to start with. Take this one off. Put this in here. Right, so why does that not play now? Try switching them. Oh shit. So I think I might have gone somewhere. Let's try and put this one in there. Hey, there you go. Nice one. Let's try and turn that right. not yet. Like 6-7-ish probably. Assuming we need to get that in here. Yeah. Let's try and do it the other way. Yeah, that's not gonna fit. Okay. Thank you. do apologise, guys. I'm just trying to figure out what I'm to do, because it doesn't, again, doesn't tell you what to do. And really, this is kind of the only game that I have kind of done this a few times with now. I think I found what I'm doing. Being funny, what you meant to do. I mean, I couldn't have gone any faster up the stairs, like. Maybe as soon as I press the button this time, I'm just gonna bolt it upstairs.
Activate the active defense energy.
Okay, we're just gonna, I don't know, are we just gonna like kind of chill? So frustrating. kills you, does it? If you stand right near to the... I thought I'd go away with that one then, personally. Times I've died on this game, but to be fair, you know, I've been playing it for about 8 hours in total now. Now I do it to myself, but I like to do it that way sometimes.
System integrity at 60%. Releasing reserves.
Meant to die, because every time I tried going over that, it killed me, or kept moving me to the side. But we'll try it again, I suppose.
System integrity at 30%.
receiving. We're receiving energy. In special line, the MPT is transmitting. All systems are running. Global reception levels are rising. New time.
So we're playing as Ralph, or Rolf. Trophy earned, what we do in life echoes. Dr. Sarah Baker, vital signs. Trophion delivers the moon. Very, very, very good game, guys. Very tricky, you know, as well, because obviously I've had to look at a few of the puzzles, which I do apologise about, but at least we got to finish the game and another one marked off. Did a whole, what, how long has it been? 9.5 hour stream, man. Longest I've ever done. And I don't think I'm ever going to do that again. So I am completely and well and truly docked. But it's a fantastic game. Did a 10 hour stream on it, but it was well worth it. I think we missed a couple bits of information, but majority of it we got. So very well put together game though, very good created game. about the sci-fi, there were some bits that were tricky, some bits weren't. I enjoyed it. Obviously at first I thought, you know, that we were on the moon to start with because of the way it looked. Obviously minus the low gravity, because obviously there was loads of gravity when we first started playing. But yeah, that was actually Earth. But we got to, I'm assuming, fix Earth. Paul Deepman, it was a very good idea, pal. I really enjoyed playing it. So, based on an idea by Paul Deepman, kudos to you. And we've got a bit of right at the end. Awesome.
Vestia 3 to ground control. We found them.
So I'm assuming Sarah and Rolf died. Right, we'll be back, guys, after the credits. Now to give my observation. Okay. I'm back. Right, thanks for watching, guys. There's not really much more to be said. I have just been looking up, actually, while obviously the credits were on. And there's actually a game called Deliverers Mars, which is a sequel to this, apparently. So, and that's only just come out, about 2 or 3 months ago, I think. So I will definitely be keeping an eye on that for the future. I have, you know, I have got another game in mind. I've already got it downloaded and it's already, you know, it's installed and everything. Yeah, very interesting, different kind of gameplay. Reminds me a lot of Mass Effect. I used to love Mass Effect, one of my favorite games, so this really did, you know, I really did enjoy it. If anything, I thought, you know, because of the starting menu, which, you know, I know it, at the end of the day, it doesn't necessarily matter 100% what your menu's like as long as the game's great. And you know, I'm not gonna lie, you know, the menu doesn't stand out like I thought, you know, it would take an hour, 2 hours, a short game, and it didn't look the type that actually looked pretty good. But I've been blown away. I've been completely putting my place in that decision. Anyway, guys, I'm completely knackered now, sitting after I've done a 9-hour stream. I hope you enjoy watching it. Obviously, I'll be doing it the same that I usually do in parts, or be split into different sections onto YouTube. And each time that I do a video now, I add a short with it. So, anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.